Hello friends, Kishan is here again and welcome you in this video tutorial. In previous video tutorial, we had discussed about the how we can run native SQL query in Hibernate and we had some theoretical discussion. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn how we can run native SQL in Hibernate. So to show this demo, just I'm taking the reference of what we had discussed in the previous video, and in previous video we had gone through the some slide, and most of the content I had taken from the Hibernate documentation website. And so if you can see over here, chapter number 17, that talks about the native SQL query in Hibernate. So let's start. So they have given some code snippet instead of entire working example. So here, if you let's go to the Eclipse, and here I have already created a project. So this project is basically Maven based. So if you go to the pom.xml, then I have declared a MySQL dependency because we are using MySQL database. So MySQL connector Java dependency as well as Hibernate 5.2.11. That's the latest version of Hibernate. Now that's all about the pom.xml. Now we have a utility class who is responsible to provide us a session factory, and if you go to the in this session factory, this utility method is not needed, so that's I'm going to remove it. Now we have a Hibernate cfg.xml which contains all the information about the Hibernate properties. Here we are using the database name is called test. Now we have a entity class is called person who is binded with the person table in database, and this contains some properties like ID, name, nickname, address, created on, and version, and corresponding column name we have specified on the top of these properties. And ID, we have a primary key that is auto generated. We are using the auto generated strategy identity. This basically uses auto increment feature of database, right? So that's all about these classes. Now we have a save data client. Here we have created a two person object, and we are basically trying to persist this person object into the database by calling save methods. So let me run this application. Before running this application, let me show you my test schema or test database. Is now there is no table in this. So HBM to DDL value we have a specify as update in Hibernate cfg.xml file. So Hibernate is going to create table for us, and this will insert two record into person table. So once you run this application, once you run this class save data client test, then this will create a database table, and that will insert our two records into person table. So here you can see TTL query table has been created, and there is two record inserted in this table. If I go over here and refresh, then you can see person table, and this is populated with the two records, right? Now we'll make use of this data to show demo on native query. So here I'm going to create a try block. Sorry guys, my computer is a bit slow. So let's have a try block, and here in catch block, if any exception is arises, then I would like to print the entire stack trace. So now in try, here I'm going to use try with resources. So first of all, you will have to get session object in Hibernate. Session equal to Hibernate util. That's the utility method we have discussed, the utility class, and which is having the gets session factory method, and you can call the open session. This will give you the session. So here if you use try with resources, then you don't need to close this session object in the finally block. This will be closed automatically end of the program. So that's the huge case. So now here I'm going to first of all call something is called create a native query method. So here you have a method create native query which we have discussed in the previous video, right? And here I'm going to pass a plain SQL query, select star from Persian, right? This is a plain SQL query, right? And I'm gonna call a method is called, now here you can call a list method on it. So if you go to the Hibernate official website, then first example they have given something like this. So this is for JPA. If you come down, then they have given example for Hibernate as well, right? So here Hibernate native query selecting all columns. So here this guy is going to return us object of array, right? So this will return you object of array as says documentation. Now you will have to use for each loop to iterate this list of object array. And here if you look into the database now, then in database from left to right, so ID would be available in the 0th index, then first index address would be available. Similarly, created on will be available in the second index, something like this, right? So here suppose I want to, you can of course you can retrieve all values, like you can retrieve, like let's suppose I want to retrieve ID. So here you can see int ID equal to, here I'm going to typecast into big integer because ID is a type of long. So if you try to retrieve from the database, this will basically retrieve in the big integer. So that's the framework does. And now we have an object, now 0th index. So this will give you the ID, right? ID of Persian, right? So let's see what is saying that. Okay, so what you can do, let's say big integer, sorry, big integer, and here also you can type us into big integer, right? So this is basically our ID, right? Sorry, something like this, and here you will have a big integer itself, no problem. Now we would like to retrieve the name. So name is data type of name is a string itself. So again you have a object of array, and what would be the index of name? So 0 1 2 3, so third index would be name. So here I'm going to use 3, right? And let's print these two values. So I would say Persian ID, and you can say ID. Similarly next SOP I'm gonna print person name. Rest of the attribute also you can print easily, right? So if you would like to retrieve address, then that would be available on the first index and you will have to typecast into a string, something like this. So, but for to save some time, just I'm going to retrieve two values and let's see whether we are able to retrieve or not. Now here you can see we got the name, there are two persons, so we got the corresponding ID and name for these two persons, and that is getting retrieved successfully. But here this will give you the all column values you need to retrieve by the index and typecast into the corresponding data type. So this is the first SQL we have ran. So what I'm going to refactor it, refactor method, and I would say get person info, and I would say v1 means version 1, right? Version 1 method. So we are going to look different versions of this method, so that's what I have given the version 1. Now next version of this method I'm going to write in a little different ways how documentation says. So I would say v2, and here let's create another method. Right, so create method, and code I'm going to copy paste from here itself, which just we have written from the scratch. And here now instead of specifying the selecting all columns, you can specify the column name as well. So ID and name I'm gonna select, and this return type would be, now here now I'm going to use add scalar, and add scalar is having a lot of overloaded method. So overloaded method, this method I'm going to use. So here I would say id, and I would say long type, and I would say instance, right? Similarly, I can call add a scalar multiple times for different columns. Now next I would like to retrieve name, and I would say a string type, I would say instance, right? So this will basically return you, and we can call the finally list method on it, right? So let's call a list method, and return type would be again object of array. So I'd say object of array, return type would be almost same. Now if I run this application, now here here again, now at this time you can typecast into long itself, you don't need to. So hibernate will give you the, because here we have specified the data type. But if you do not specify data type, then long will be retrieved as a big integer from the database. And here we can see the output. Now here saying that, yes, one mistake we have done. Now array index would be id for 0 and name for 1. So here we will have to say 1. In last API we haven't given the index. So index would be the how you have declared in the database. Now let's see how we get the output. Sorry guys, my Eclipse is running a bit slow. Now you can see we retrieve the ID and name for the both persons. So this is the second version of this API. Now third version I'm going to use, version third I'm going to use. So let's say I'm going to paste it over here, and I would say v3. So I'm going to comment it, and let's make call to this guy, and let's say this is v3. So as we had discussed in the previous video, so here when you use add scalar, then specifying type would be not mandatory. See here, that is optional. So name automatically will be typecasted into the string. If you remove the type, then still this is going to be worked. Let's see after removing this type for the name, this is running or not. So that we had discussed in the previous videos, if you would have watched my previous video tutorial. Now you can see still we are able to retrieve the name as well as the ID for both the persons. Now last but not the least, we are going to look how we can retrieve the entity, right? So let me freeze up to here in this video, because I'm running out of time. So we have seen three versions of the get person info when you have a scalar values, right? A scalar values means you are not going to retrieve the complete object, but you are going to retrieve the certain columns, right? So running SQL like this is very tedious, or very what you can say. So it's not good idea to run SQL query like this. So in next video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to retrieve the entity, right? While running the SQL, how we can map the result with the entity class itself. So thanks for watching this video, and don't forget to watch second part of this video. So this code I'm going to put on the GitHub, and GitHub location will get in the video description. So see you in next video tutorial.